Let's move with the next set. Now here we have the first question which says X can complete 20% of the work in 8 days. That means to complete whole of the work, how many days he would require? He would require 40 days because 20% can be completed in 8 days. So in how many days he would complete 100% of his work? So that would be 40 days. Similarly, if Y can complete 25% of the work in 6 days, that means 25% is completed in 6 days. So to complete whole of the work, he would require 24 days. Now, we do 1 by 40 plus 1 by 24. So that is where you would require the work done, that is the total work done. Now, this total work done would be how much? We would have to calculate 40% of it. So we'll first find out this value. Now, once we find out this value, we would multiply it by 0.4, and then we would find this value, take a inverse and then multiply it by 0.4, and this would give us how many days? 6 days. So 6 days would be the right option. The next is, a car travels from place X to Y at a speed of V. So it goes at a speed of V, returns at 2V, then goes at 3V, returns at 4V, and so on. Okay. Then what is the average speed for the entire journey? So what would happen? Average speed is equal to distance by time. What is the total distance? It is 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1, consider it to be 4. Okay. And what is the time? So time is again distance by speed. So distance by speed, which is V, then 1 by 2V plus 1 by 3V plus 1 by 4V. We solve this and this value would be somewhere between V and 2V. So you would have V as the right option. The next question is, the minimum number of points of intersection of a circle and a square can be 0 because in a plane the circle and the square can be located anywhere. Now if within the square the circle is there, you would have 4 points of intersection that would be there. If there is a square within a circle, again you would have 4 points, but in one of the cases you would have 8 points, and that is with each of the surfaces cutting twice, you would have 8 maximum intersection points that could be seen. Okay, so first is incorrect, second is correct. You would have 2 only as the right option here. The next question says, a man takes half the time in rowing a certain distance downstream then upstream. So what is the ratio of the speed in the still water to the speed of the current? So it would be, the ratio would be half in the case of downstream. So I can write it as 2:1. I can simply solve it and it would be 3:1 ratio. So 3:1 would be the right answer. The next is, how many pairs of natural numbers are there with the difference of their squares as 63? So 1 and 64. So 1 square and 8 square, 6 square, that is 36, and 10 square. Then you would have 9 square, that is 81, and 12 square, 144. So you would have 1, 2, and 3. 3 pairs are there that would be the having the difference of the squares as 63. The next question is, I'm adding 5 to both the numerator and the denominator and then I'm finding out the minimum change. So let's take the example of the first and the last. So obviously it could be either the first or the last. So you would have 2 by 3 plus 5 plus 5, that is 7 by 8 minus 2 by 3. So that would be a bigger value. However, I would do it for 5 by 6. So it would be 10 by 11 minus 5 by 6, and this would be a smaller value. So 5 by 6 would be the right option. The next question is, a digit n greater than 3 is divisible by 3 but not divisible by 6. So a digit which is divisible by 3 and not divisible by 6, that means it's multiple of 3 but not 2, is 9. Now I replace n with 9 and see which of the following would make it true. So if n is equal to 9, in the first case this is 18. Okay, so that is divisible by not divisible by 4. So this is incorrect. Then you would have 3 into 9, that is 27, again not divisible. Then you would have 18, 22, again not divisible. Here it would be 27 plus 1, which is 28, and this is divisible by 4. So D is the right option. The next question is, 1 liter of water weighs 1 kg. Now, 1 cubic millimeters of water would weigh how many cubic millimeters of water will weigh 0.1 grams. Now, we would have 1 million cubic meters of water would be equal to 1 liter, and 1 liter is equal to 1 kg. I converted into 1 gram, so it would be 1000 cubic meters. Now again, I want it for 0.1, so it would be 100. So 100 would be the right option here. The next question is, a vessel full of water weighs 40. If it is 1/3 filled, then its weight would become 20. What is the weight of the empty vessel? Now, how do we calculate? In this case, let the weight of the vessel plus the weight of the water would be 40. In the second case, when the weight of the vessel and the weight of the water is 20, okay, if it is 1/3 filled. Now, I have two equations and two variables. I can solve those. And solving those, I get the weight of the empty vessel is 10 kgs. So, 10 kgs would be the right option. This is a very standard question. Every off and on, you have such questions. So, frog jumps 30 centimeters and slides 15 centimeters. So, it's moving 30 centimeters up, sliding 15 centimeters. So, net gain every time with every jump is 15 centimeters. Now, the well is 4.5 meters, which is 450 centimeters. So, 450 divided by 15 is 30. Now, at the 30th jump, it would be on the brim of the well. So, it would be basically out of the well at the 30th jump. It need not to have an extra jump to move out. The next question talks about bank credit. Now, here we are talking about how banks have been failing and there is no proper infrastructure to shut down the banks. Even the loss-making units continue. However, they need every time more of cash and capital infusement that is there. So, from the above passage, the most logical inference that could be drawn is India lacks an institutional mechanism to deal with the failure of the banks. So, that is the right option here. The next is, we have good potentials for solar energy. We are talking about 33% of cutting down of the emissions through a gas-based economy and relying on to renewable energy. So, which is the most logical inference? The most logical inference is getting renewable resources to market too soon may be costly, because in the last line it clearly says that business houses are investing heavily in the renewable energy when the technology is not ready. That means the technology is still yet costly and not yet ready. Okay, so you would have C as the right option. The next question talks about the solid waste management, and there is a kind of heaps of garbage that is being there. Also, the untreated sewage goes into the drain, which basically blocks the path and the drains and lead to stagnation of water, which is one of the major breeding grounds for mosquitoes. So, what does the author tries to highlight here? The idea is that solid waste management must be integrated with maintenance of drainage systems and sewerage network, and then only all these issues and problems could be resolved. So, efficient solid waste management system should be taken into consideration. The next question talks about fundamental rights and the right to religion. So, religious freedom under constitution is open to state intervention because it clearly says it is subject to public order, morality, health and to other provisions of this part. So, therefore, we clearly understand that it is based on the understanding that there is religious freedom under constitution, but it is open to state intervention. So, B is the right option. The next is, there are 5-lettered word, which is Delhi. Now, D and I being kept constant, I am just moving E, L and H. So, what can be the combination? So, 3 into 2 into 1, which is 6. So, 6 possible moves can be there. The next question is, A bottle contains 20 liter of liquid A. So in the first instance, there is 20 liter liquid A and liquid B. So it is A is 20, B is 0. In the second instance, it becomes 16 and this becomes how much? 4. But in the third instance, what we do is 16 minus, you would have 4 divided by 20 into 16. Okay, and here it would be 4 minus 1 by 4 by 20 multiplied by 4, and then again 4 liters of the mixture is taken out and replaced by same quantity of liquid B. So 4 is added again to it. So when we solve this, the ratio comes out to be 64 and 36. Simplifying it, it would be 16:9. So 16:9 would be the right option. The next question is, the average score of the batsman after 50th inning is so much. So it is 50. The total score is 50 into 46.4. Okay. After the 60th inning, it is how much? So 60 into 46.4 plus 2.6, that is 0.1. That is 9 and 49. So 49 into 60, and this whole divided by how much? The 10 innings. So divided by 10, and this would give you the answer as 62. So just solve it and you would have 62 as the answer. The next question is, as a result of 25% hike in the price of rice per kg, a person is able to purchase 6 kg less rice for 1200 rupees. What is the original price? So here we have 1200 as the price, okay, and the initial cost is 100x, okay. Now what is the price hike? Price hike is 25%, so the new cost here is 125x, and this would, the difference of this would be how much? 6 kgs. So solving this, I have 2.4 divided by x is equal to 6. So x is equal to 0.4, that is 2.4 divided by 6. Now this is x. I need to have the original price, which is 100x. So 100x would be 100 into 0.4, that makes it 40. So 40 rupees is the right option. So this was the next set of 20 questions. We would be covering the last set of 20 questions, and for any information and detailed solutions, just visit the links below. Have a wonderful day ahead.